Hi, I'm Aparna Ganesh and I welcome you to our series Yoga and You. Your questions have been coming to us and our dear Hansaji, the Yoga Institute Director, has been answering them for us. Hansaji, every 5 years there seems to be new trends in food, there are new diet plans, there are so much trends and you know, so much happening that people are just confused as to what really to follow and you know. So is there like simple rules you can share with them, like 5 foods to avoid completely rather than what you should eat? If you just say okay, you know, okay. Is there a ground rule that we can follow?
Oh, nowadays so many new theories are coming up and so on, but according to yoga, certain things you should really avoid if you can, because if there is no food available, then to survive you have to eat. That's a very different matter. But now such situation doesn't
usually don't happen. If you're conscious and you want to, yeah. You know,
but if you have a choice to avoid, you have to avoid these 5 types of food. One very strongly we say is stale food. Mm-hmm. Stale food, you have cooked today, you are eating tomorrow, you are eating day after. That stale food has to be avoided. Mm. Second, recooked. You are cooking again and again the same food.
Mm. You mean reheating?
Reheating. Okay. Reheating. Refrying. You see, vada is done and then again you fry and eat, again it is left, again to make it hot you fry and eat, such stuffs. So anything which you eat from outside, majority of the time they are re-cooked, re-fried, and that we would say totally avoid. See, all these things like you open the bottle and drink and open the packet and eat, all these ready-made products just ready to eat. They all have preservatives. They are all artificially colored, flavored, vitaminized, mineralized. So all such things should be avoided. Eat natural food, not these things. Then comes whites, all whites. Say excess of salt, excessive of sugar, refined things. Mm. Refined maida, you know, wheat flour, but totally refined, so made out of maida. So I would straight away say all the bakery products, which is nothing else but full of maida. They are all very tasty. You take butter and you take crispy toast and all that, but avoid, please avoid. Never ever take it morning breakfast, which usually people take. Now this bread, it is maida after all.
And even brown bread is largely
yes. Yeah. I mean 80% is maida, 20% is if at all wheat flour, but it is preferably maida, and such things should never be taken in breakfast because they are. In breakfast, your body is so much ready to absorb and assimilate everything out of what you eat. And here you are putting junk food, which has nothing to give your body. It is not right. And so those things you should avoid. And then definitely all these nerve stimulants, basically alcohol and all such brothers and sisters of the same group, you know, I would say avoid, because the after effect is definitely tamasic, dull, depressive. And we have to live our life enthusiastically. We can't be depressive. And so avoid, totally avoid. Because I have noticed that people who take these things once in a while, somewhere they always find the reason to take this more. You are tired, so you are taking, you are unhappy, so you are taking, today you are
frustrated.
And therefore
forms the addiction.
You know, it's an addiction. So all these addictive things,
which would include tea and coffee, right?
I have a big list of all the addictive things like tea, coffee, cocoa, wine, liquor, tobacco, cigarette, and more other addictive, brown sugar, hashish, marijuana, LSD, bhang, ganja, charas. The list is on and on. So
you would say cocoa also in this? Like, I mean, chocolate?
Fine. I mean, if I would say avoid, people are going to take. Now, this is another question that you may say avoid. Now, you avoid salt, you avoid refined sugar. But then I would say that have a healthy alternative, no? So instead of this refined things, refined sugar, have
jaggery.
And even that rock sugar, which is called as mishri, something where you will see fibers of sugar cane. In that, you know, such, you can make a powder and drink, take that in case. And jaggery, of course, jaggery, honey, all these things are good. You know, even dates and such things, nowadays people make out of, you know, a sweetener. they soak dates and then take out the pulp and mix it with milk and take it as a sugar. I mean, it's a sweet thing. Date is very sweet. Date, figs, soak them and make it into a paste and keep it in the house. So whatever, if you want to sweeten up anything, just put one or two spoon and take it. So have such healthy alternative. You should eat sweets, no doubt, but then you should have such healthy things. Salt. Now salt, rock salt, why not to take rock salt? You know, sendha namak and black salt, kala namak, that salt which you put in chaat masalas and salt you put in pani puri, those salts are very good. You should use them rather than white and refined salts and
table
other
salt,
salt table
yeah.
salts and iodized salts and all these refined things, avoid.
Hansaji, when you said stale food, after how many hours of cooking is the food considered stale?
24 hours roughly. So if I am cooking today in the morning, by tomorrow morning it is stale. So from morning to evening it is fine. Evening to morning it is fine, but morning to next day morning is stale.
Hansaji, when we talk of also reheating, there is always a debate on the usage of microwave. Can you please tell us what your thoughts are? Because
well, microwave, do you know what happens? It is drying the system, drying the thing. It makes it dry, so it removes all the nutrients from the system. You heat in microwave, you are eating only for fibers in your body, the whole nutrition is gone. So I am never ever of an opinion that you should eat more microwaves. Liquid water, you can little bit warm it up. For such things it is fine, but cooking in microwave, I would say always avoid. Little bit warming it up, it's fine. Like milk, thanda, it's cold little, you put it in the microwave and warm it up. Water, you want warm, microwave. It is fast.
But yeah, it's very
anything
convenient.
According to nature, when it is fast, it is not
questionable.
So, yes, right.
Hansaji, to just sum up the five things that you said, first thing you said was to not eat stale food.
Stale food.
The second one you said was not to eat reheated food.
Correct.
The third was package, which includes aerated water and anything that you can open up directly from the box and eat.
All these things like chips.
Yeah.
And packets are ready. You just open and eat. Yeah. Avoid. When you say what to avoid, my first opinion would be, don't give too much emphasis on what you are eating. I would say how you are eating, how much you are eating, that is more harmful.
Yeah.
How much, if you are not hungry, totally avoid eating food. Don't eat food, only have some liquids, have lemon juice. Anything other than water is food. Understand the definition. Water is not a food. Water is water. And that needs a separate place and separate way you have to handle it. Food. Now it's a liquid food which has lots of water inside, lemon juice. Take that. But don't eat food where you have to chew or gulp it and eat. Avoid if you are not hungry. So that is one point. Second, when you are really angry, disturbed, don't eat food. Again, take some liquid.
Right.
So the moment you are disturbed, adrenaline secretes, hydrochloric acid secretes into your body. Your body is full of toxin. And then you are eating food. What will body do? Body will store the food or throw it out, but never utilize it. Never absorb, assimilate and convert it into energy. Not possible. So then we start having a diseases because of food. Ayurveda says root cause of all disease lies in stomach only. So how you are eating becomes very important. So become alert and aware. Rather, I would say that when you sit to eat, see that your mind is calm. You take one slow, long breath. There are families who do prayer also. So do prayer in your mind. So calm yourself down and then eat. That would give you maximum benefit. So that's how we have to live our life.
So the third point was not to eat packaged food. The fourth was to avoid
artificially colored, flavored, vitaminized, mineralized products.
Right.
And then refined products.
Right. So which includes maida and so many things. So if it's bakery,
maida.
Nowadays
bakery.
You have plenty of stuff with ragi and with so many other
things. Go ahead.
Things,
yeah. Why not? Eat
yeah.
it.
Yeah.
People are also getting conscious, I tell you.
Absolutely.
Nowadays, people are getting health conscious. So there are certain foods which are baked rather than fried. So we have even a machine in the kitchen.
There are air fryers and stuff.
Air fryers are there. Yeah. Well, such things should be used. Why not?
Oh, lovely. Five power tips of what you can avoid to live a healthy life from Hansaji. So there is a lot more to than just picking and being nitpicky about food, your state of mind, your quality of food, the proportion of food. There's so much more to it. I hope we can all have a balanced outlook when we approach food and enjoy it. I'm sure you're enjoying all the conversations that I'm having with Hansaji. Plenty of tips there for a better life and a healthier you. So share this with your friends, like the video and subscribe to the channel for continuing all the wisdom flowing right from Hansaji to you.